Okay, Debbie. You got this.
Do we have to talk to her? She's like the girl you wish you hadn't started talking to at a covert briefing.
No, she strikes me more as like, you know, one of the mean girls.
Oh god.
She was definitely a mean girl in high school.
Seriously.
I'm sorry, this area falls under the jurisdiction of the Department of Homeland Security. I'd suggest finding another
place
to play.
Her words are often nice, but there's like,
she's got resting bitch voice.
Yeah, everything she's
about signing up for active duty. Mm-hmm. I'd call that a smart career move, seeing as how you're operating heavy artillery on American soil without the appropriate authorization. The armed forces could use a soldier like yourself with the proper training, of course.
Did that? Got the PTSD.
You've all of you got potential, but the edges are rough and your powers aren't being channeled in a very productive or legal manner.
Frankly, see?
You're a ticking bomb. A walking threat to the security of the United States of America.
We're the Illuminati. You are the law. But yeah, I definitely see.
We've got enough on our plate to deal with right now, but when the crisis has been averted, and it will be averted, I'd recommend for your own sake to either be wearing the right uniform or to cause chaos on another continent entirely. Are we clear?
It's like everything she says is a carefully worded legal statement by someone who just wants to say, go shove a cactus up your butt, but doesn't want to get sued.
I'll tell you one thing, kid. This isn't my first brush with the supernatural. Far from it. Our unit has seen some action. Johannesburg in 87, Siberia in 93, Rio in 08. Last month, we spent a good 4 days knee-deep in New Yorker excrement, hunting a flock of incubi that got separated from their mistress. They turned feral. Did you know that?
Yes, I...
They lose control. Used to be you could parley with the succubi. Avoid too much bloodshed. The rules have changed. There's no negotiating with the enemy anymore.
And that's not what we're suggesting, sir, but I'm not sure that taking our limited resources into a mono-a-mono testosterone-fueled battle royale... This is not our brief. And I shouldn't have to remind you who's running the operation. Even if we can't get a signal through the fog, it's the Para-Division.
I've got scars all over, and I'm not just talking about the ones that bleed. But if I've learned one thing in the past 40 years, it's that they bleed too. Every single one of them.
Yes, they do, sir, but so do we. And we bleed out a lot faster than they... Ugh! I don't even know why I fucking bother with this fucking... What the hell are you looking at?
Okay, suddenly I understand her a lot more. I don't like her, but I understand her. Oh, well, if they can't help them, I'll go. But yeah, I get her now. Sarge is really being your condescending dick there.
Captain Sarge McDickface.
I mean, at first I liked Sarge, but then I started to remember, and like, yeah.
Local bounty detected. Initiating.
Guessing that's shit you don't want to talk about.
You know, you're indoctrinated to look up to people like him.
Oh my god, they're alive.
Yeah. They're alive.
Holy shit.
Watch out. Hold.
For the moment.
Quick. This guy knows what's up.
Boys, Loki, have an intruder. We have to hold this point.
What are you even holding here?
I think it's just like their last defensible position.
Guys, fall back.
I mean,
I don't, damn the orders, fall back.
They have the high ground.
Yeah, they can't really escape.
No. It's gonna, like, stand here, fall. It just won't stop.
Oh! Great. Oh, great.
Come on.
Poison. The poison.
Are they following you?
I'm gonna make a distraction.
Alright, good. Look at me, I'm a target!
Thanks. So... this one would be the leader.
Mm-hmm. He's the big brain thing.
Yes, the big brain things are the leaders. We have figured this out from, trial and error.
Yeah. Honestly, a lot of the details of the life cycle are still lost on me. But I can... I know the big glowy brain thing, probably the leader.
Ah, okay. At least they did some good getting them... letting them pull out of there.
Yeah, I don't think they could hold off without you.
For now, go to the one in the Ash Forest. We can pick up the runes. Whoa, hello!
He's a skeleton crew.
Oh, this isn't spooky.
3 spooky, 5 me.
Okay, this is actually really spooky.
I'm sorry, I can't get over the pun in that name.
The old bone, see, like the old undead, they tend to rise up where they were buried.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And just hang around there.
Oh dear.
Mind just burying people who died here?
Shit.
Oh, what the hell? Ghosts? Budsheet ghosts?
I think that's just a sheet. A parachute.
I think it's a... bedsheet? Oh, a parachute, yeah. Oh. Huh.
Did you think it was a bedsheet ghost?
I don't know! It was confusing.
Well, we've already met Old Man Winters, who owns the Haunted Amusement Park.
Is it just, like, sort of dingy in here?
I mean,
like, grimy.
There were mines in this area, weren't there? Maybe it's just covered in... Well, then again, this is the Ash Forest.
Were these ash trees?
I could not tell you what kind of tree it is.
Oh. Well, there are ghosts here.
Of course there are.
Funeral marcher.
Yeesh.
Is this like some death cult in here too?
I don't know. Maybe I couldn't even begin to understand, really. The only thing I can imagine is that, like, apparently this is so dangerous that even people traveling through here on their way to funerals wound up dying.
Wow. Okay, this is not a safe house. This is a cabin in the woods. This is definitely a cabin in the woods.
This is a murder cabin.
We see the Western Spectres. Regardless of the era of their death, they usually manifest in bedraggled turn-of-the-century finery, a slow parade through the ragtime dirges, and drowned pavilions of a frigid, underwater otherworld. Descriptions of this chthonic place match a score of submerged and forgotten towns from previous centuries, from Bittersweet to Minnewanka to Dingebine. Perhaps their anachronistic attire is the expressed contrast to the incessant changes of our own living world.
Whoa.
That was rather... that was almost coherent.
That was deep, man. That's like deep.
Also, look at this.
Yeah, that's... fuck. I'm more surprised.
Holy shit! Whoa!
Oh, you brought friends.
The hell?
Scarlet Conductor? Jesus.
The conductor and the waltzers and the marchers. This was a...
Shit, a whole marching band die here?
And the female ghosts are called waltzers.
Oh man, I'm not sure how literal any of this is. So you know the movie Wonder Woman like nearly didn't have the scene where she like, you know, goes across no man's land? Because Warner Brothers were all like, she's spending too much time saving people. She should be fighting bad guys. And it's kind of like here, you know, it's like they, at some point, like, you get, you know, too cynical to recognize the importance of, like, just helping people.
Yeah, I'm helping get these guys out of here.
Yeah.
But that probably means, well, they have a much better position. They have auto turrets here, you know? Auto turrets is like...
Oh, yeah.
They can probably hold out.
I don't know how well they hold out against ghosts, but, you know, anything's...
They have magic bullets. Sarge was talking about those earlier.
Oh, yeah, right. Of course.
We have to hold this point. Supply time is a watch. Tell HQ we are hip deep in it. Hold. We have to hold this point.
Jeez, these ghosts really
shit.
Want it.
Yeah.
What's, like, directing ghosts?
I don't know, I mean, we already killed the conductor.
That was a wraith, it's probably gonna come back.
Everybody fall in.
Oh my god.
We have to hold this point.
Idol of Carnage.
What the fuck? What kind of messed up shit was going on here?
I don't know.
I think you're right. I think this definitely must have been a death cult. You don't get Idols of Carnage at your Bible study.
Depends on what your Bible is.
That is true.
Akin?
Akin? A-H-K-I-N?
Yeah.
Huh.
Halkan?
Oh, you're not gonna like this.
What?
It's Mayan.
Fucking Mayan. Wait, what are Mayans doing in here?
I don't know.
Oh my god, there's a Cobb and there's... Mayans! They're controlling the Akkad?
That... Oh, Jesus.
The Mayans control the Akkad?
Maybe the Mayans brought the Akkad here.
My first instinct was to say that's ridiculous, but... You know what? Fuck it. That must be what happened. That has to be what happened.
It's the only thing that makes... Not sense, but you know.
Yeah. Like how...
The secrets of ward maintenance are passed down the generations, but entropy ends dedication when flavored with time. Indifference pushes the people of the dawn apart. Indifference and something else. Skullduggery, sweetling. A malefactor. We detect an outside influence.
I think the bees are kind of like your conspiracy friend who doesn't believe in the moon landings.
What's that Godar?
Godar? That's Icelandic, so these are probably Vikings.
Norsemen arrive in their longboats and bring an artifact to the Wabanaki. Its transcendent vibrations amplify the wards, making them sing. It becomes the only key that can open the door. The Vikings take it back with them across the ocean.
The sword.
Oh my god, we have Wabanaki, Vikings, and Mayans all here. What the sh...
Man.
What happened here?
Yeah. Too bad we can't just, like, go into the past.
Or can... No, you're right. That's a silly thing.
Yeah, time travel. Time travel doesn't exist, does it?
And if it did, it would just really complicate things.
Anyway. I can't activate this one yet.
Oh, you must have to do them in order. So yeah, we should have done the one when back there.
I shouldn't have done the one right there. What if that is up there?
The moon?
No.
I'm a little confused. Like, where are you trying to go? Because it seems like you're going away from the mission marker.
It's a little hard to get there from here.
Okay.
See? I was here.
Yeah.
And, oh, I guess that would be easier. Okay, you have a point.
Thank you.
Okay, fine. Have to go back through the skeleton forest. I don't want to know how many skeletons are chasing me.
Yeah, it must be a switchback for the mine carts.
This looks like a factory or something where they're probably like processing the ore.
Yeah. Oh my, look at that.
It's rocks.
Looks like just someone's model they made with like lumps of clay and pipe cleaners. Except big and trying to kill you.
Okay, so go through here. That's back down.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Maybe you should ask for directions.
Excuse me, sir. Oh, dead drog. I think I'm going the right way.
Follow the trail of dead drog. Oh. Oh.
Yeah, damn.
No, you're kind of panning away.
Oh. Oh, damn.
How did you not see that?
Oh, damn.
Holy shit. I mean...
Well, that might be what's causing the satellite interference. What do you think?
I think so. I think that's pretty damn likely.
That's like...
I mean, it's oddly... beautiful in an apocalyptic kind of way.
It's producing the fog.
Yeah. Wait a second, I thought the fog came in from the sea.
It did, but now the fog's on the island.
That's fucked up.
Which means they must have had one of those with them. Which means, but how could they have one of those mobile... Unless...
And how'd they get it this far
in... The ship!
Wait, how'd they get it this far inland, though? I mean, this is like the middle of a quarry.
They would have... They had to grow it since they arrived here.
Oh.
But no. I figured it out.
What?
Oh, God, these guys are dead. I'll tell you after I kill this bitch.
Okay.
Thank you. goes to show why the Pentagon's default response is still nuke it from orbit, even with all the paranormal agencies they've got advising them. You know, bombing the ever-living shit out of a bad situation has worked for them, and by proxy, us, before. I hope you didn't think the nuclear tests were actually tests. That's adorable. Trouble is, it's so much harder to explain away now. That's why the default budget buck still stops with these poor assholes on the ground. They died for American values, they'll say. Not from being eaten by bugs in Maine. In Maine? God. Wow, that seems to have even bothered her.
I said I'd never thought I'd see the day.
Yeah. I figured it out.
What?
The Polaris. Why they needed it.
They needed to drag that thing on it.
Yeah. I saw tentacles, but I didn't even see the pod.
Oh. Shit.
Tentacles were this size, yeah. I mean, there might have been a different pod. Like, maybe they left that one to die after they were done with it. But this is the same thing as on the ship. They needed the Polaris for a mobile invasion platform.
Jesus, these things could figure that out, though. Like, they look like, they seem like just mindless, you know, Norse Cthulhu zombies. But, oh my god.
They're intelligent.
That was actually a pretty good plan.
And it worked.